Hi friends, so in this video we are gonna see how to find out the Jacobian of composite function. So let's start. So if let's say u and v are differentiable function, of R and S, and let's say R and S are differentiable function of X and Y. So here we are considering a condition of composite function, that is U and V are function of R and S and R and S are function of X and Y. Now let's see what would be the Jacobian of this composite function. So Jacobian of UV with respect to XY will be given by Jacobian of UV with respect to RS into Jacobian of RS with respect to X and Y. So this is the formula which we are gonna use to find out the Jacobian of composite function. Now to explain this concept in detail, let's see one example. So here X, Y and Z are given in terms of U, V and W. I'll say X, Y and Z are the function of U, V and W. Next, U is given as function of R, theta and phi. V is given function of R theta and phi, and also W is function of R theta and phi. Now the question is, what is Jacobian of X, Y, Z with respect to R theta and phi? Now here, if you'll observe, X, Y, Z is given in terms of U, V, W, and U, V, W is given in terms of R theta and phi. So it is a composite function. So let's start. So to find out the Jacobian of X, Y, Z with respect to R, theta and phi, the formula would be Jacobian of X, Y, Z with respect to U, V, W and Jacobian of U, V, W with respect to Jacobian of R, theta and phi. So I'll give this as equation number one. And to get the value of this left hand side, I'll first of all find the values of these two terms and substitute in the equation number 1 so that we'll get our final answer. So now let's start with the first Jacobian. So the first Jacobian is XYZ with respect to UVW. Now we all know the formula. It is a determinant of 9 elements. So the values in the determinant are as follows. That is, so we'll find these 9 values. So let's start with the first value. So dou x by dou u. Here x is not function of u, hence we'll get this value as 0. Next, what is dou x by dou v? So partial differentiation of x with respect to v would be root w is the constant, and derivative of this root v is 1 upon 2 root v. So that will become root of w upon 2 root of v. Similarly, partial differentiation of x with respect to w will be, and similarly we'll get all the values as follows. Now this is the value that we got after finding the partial differentiation of this term. Now let's solve the determinant. So we'll get